Without acknowledging him. So while you're doing what you're doing, I'm going to do what I normally do. Dear Lord, this morning we thank you. We thank you for the peaceful rest that we received on last night, for the angels you dispatched around our bedsides to protect us from all hurt, harm, and danger. You touched us with your wondrous, loving hand, and our eyes opened to a brand new day. This day, Lord, we've never witnessed, but in your words you said, this is the day that I have made, and you are to rejoice and be glad in it. And so we are here, Lord, to say thank you. We love you, we praise you, we magnify you, and we lift you up because you are so worthy to be praised. We ask you to bless each and everyone here today, those who had a desire to be here but could not, for those who are encumbered to have loved ones that are going through what we consider mental illness, because Lord, we know you make no trash. You make nothing imperfect. But we ask that you strengthen us, help us to do your will, and give us the knowledge we need to love each other. In Christ we pray. Amen.
Thank you for that prayer. I think we all took it to heart. My name is Steve Dubois. This is my better half. My better half, Karen Dubois. We have a little bit of sadness. We've lost one of our board members here on October the 3rd. I'm going to read this, and if you would, go over to the education tent and sign the poster and everything that we have for him. This young man's name is Jason Wheel. He's been on our board for quite some time. On this past Wednesday, October the 3rd, 2012, at 1 p.m. in the afternoon, our wonderful friend and co-worker in disability and advocacy issues, Jason Wheel, was abruptly taken from our lives. It took his passing for us to realize just how much we all loved him and how much he had impacted our lives and countless other lives. He served on the Lenawee Acadiana Board for many years and was our current board vice president. His passion was for all those with disabilities, whether they be physical or mental, and that they be treated with fairness, kindness, and respect. He understood these issues on a personal level because, as many of you know, he had Asperger's disorder. Daily, he saw to it that his purpose was to confront stigma, disrespect, cruelty, bullying, denial of adequate care, and reward on behalf of others. His body of work against stigma is immeasurable, as his constant vigilance was truly a force to be reckoned with. When someone justifiably drew his ire, his immediate response was still always dignified and well said. When you received a rebuke from Jason, you knew you deserved it. And I speak for all the newspapers that wrote those articles. He served on many boards all over the state and made a real difference on each one. The longer you knew Jason, the more you were able to see how very intelligent, articulate, and knowledgeable he was. And he will move a meeting right on down the road. This is a profound loss, not only for Lenawee Acadiana, but for our entire state. We are proud to have served alongside of him and have called him friend. The purple iris is a symbol of hope for Lenawee. Let us observe a moment of silence. I said, let us observe a moment of silence. I'll say it one more time for those of you that weren't listening. Let's observe a moment of silence as we, in his memory, release these balloons to honor his passing.